Okay. So stories have kind of become the thing. They're extremely big on Instagram as well as Facebook. And I feel like if you are just posting in your feed, whether it be Facebook or Instagram or both, you're really missing a big network. There are people that really just look at stories right now. So utilizing that, I think, is key. A lot of people don't like, these are just based off conversations that I have had recently with people not associated with the business, that they feel in their feed, they see more, not just sales, but more politically based posts or things that they're not that interested in seeing. Stories have kind of become where people share about their day, their kids, their pets, cooking videos of like themselves cooking dinner, meals and recipes, how to things like how to do your hair in the morning or like brief little makeup clips or different things like that. Is really what people are looking for in stories. Now, the more consistently you are with your stories, the more Facebook is going to, the more your page is weighted. So it's going to be shared with more people. I did a live yesterday just for the drawing, the host post drawing that I had done for my team. And no, not right now. Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, I was babysitting her stuffed animal dog yesterday and she needed a report if he was good or not. So I did a live yesterday and today I go back and I look at my views, and that is something that I take very seriously because that tells me either I'm doing something right or I'm doing something wrong. Now, yesterday since my live, my views have doubled just in one day on my stories. I don't love live videos, but I will tell you that is a suggestion and something to start doing. Not necessarily in your story. I just did it on my main page and then automatically loaded to my story. Another thing is videos in general, just videos. If you are somebody who wakes up every single morning and makes your coffee, one morning, do a video of you making your coffee. It doesn't have to be live. It can be just a brief, you know, you don't even necessarily have to be talking if you don't want to. I think that it's beneficial. It could be just of your hands adding the water, adding the mix, adding the chocolate greens, using the frother to stir it, adding whatever you add to it, and adding the benefits. If you make brief clips of this, you can add it to your story. Any type of video is going to be huge in your feed. Not just of products, but if you are somebody who maybe you're on a health journey and you're cooking healthier meals right now and you're yourself trying new things, right? I would have maybe a quick video just of your plate of food. I did that when I was on vacation. I don't cook, so I won't be doing that, but you could do a little video of it. You can have little clips of what you are doing to make that recipe. If you can turn something into a video rather than a photograph, it's going to be bigger, if that makes sense. So if you have your keto coffee in the morning, it could be a video just of you swirling the video around your cup or your plate of dinner along with the recipe or something like that. If you're good at hair, if you're good at makeup, your kids are playing, if you are walking your dogs, just like a 5-second video of your dogs walking in front of you, anything like that. It's just really a story and a journey of your day, if that makes sense. So not just business posts and not just product posts, but making sure it's of you. And I've said this on many of my team calls before, is whatever's in your feed should be the 5 things that would describe you as a person that are important to you. If it is your kids, if it's your spouse, if it's maybe it's your 9-to-5 job that you like so much, you know, maybe it's cooking or whatever it is. Those are the things that you should be posting and sharing about consistently, not just in your feed, but in your stories as well. Funny quotes. I like to go to Pinterest and type in Instagram story templates, or you can do this or that templates, and it gives you the option to like circle? Do you prefer sunsets or sunrise? Those things are just fun. And I think a really fun way for people to get to know you. So if you put yours in there and you circle your options, then in the next screen, post the blank one and maybe write something on it that says, now let's see yours, if that makes sense. Something to that effect. So people know, like, maybe to complete theirs, maybe it's, let me see yours, tag me in it. And then you've got the next screen for them too, like a blank template of that, if that makes sense. Adding GIFs to your stories. It's almost like, I don't want to say it's like a video, but I get way more views when I do GIFs on my stories. So we tend to follow top leaders and such. Don't be afraid to go and look at their stories as well and get some inspiration. What are they posting about? What are they sharing about? A lot of them are doing stories on making their coffee in the morning. If it's, you know, your collagen that you're mixing, if you're doing the celery now, those are things to start sharing about. Now, a couple apps that are really, really good to create your own are going to be InstaStory. And what I like about the InstaStory app is that you can add photos or videos. I'll just try and pull it up for you guys. Okay, so this right down here, hold on, is what it looks like. Tap on it and it has a bunch of different templates for you guys to use. If you click, oh, let's try that one. If you click on it, you can then add either a photo or the video we talked about earlier. If you make your keto coffee and you have like a quick video to do, or a couple videos, maybe you want to do a quick five to 10 second video of you mixing it, maybe another one of you holding it, whatever it is. You can add a video, not just a photo, into that, which I think is super fun. And what that allows is at the bottom where it has, some writing, you can click on that and you can edit out the wording to be whatever you want about your coffee. This is, you know, how I make my fat-burning coffee or whatever the verbiage is. And you can do that and add to your story, creating your own. I would also recommend, I got a lot of good feedback with potential distributors when I did this, but I went in and made or had different selfies of myself. And I went in and added my photo to basically this template here, typed in a little something about myself. I probably did about 5, maybe 6, made those of myself. They were all different photos of me and my story. Joined this business 3 years ago because XYZ. The next screen might be what it had done for me, if that makes sense. So it just kind of keeps telling my story in a few different slides. I would encourage you to do that of yourself. And again, when you load it into your stories, just adding fun little GIFs and things like that to it. Really anything. Like if instead of me typing on one of my stories, swipe up, I might go to the GIF feature and type in swipe up, and they have fun little GIFs that say swipe up rather than me typing it, if that makes sense. Thank you. So those are some apps that I really like to use when it comes to stories. I think that it keeps them very clean and gives you a lot of different options and different backgrounds that you can use. Let's see if there was another one. Okay, I think that was it. So doing both on Instagram and on Facebook, if you are not big on posting on Instagram, just start with stories. Just start with your engagement there because people do view stories as well. Okay, so sometimes I will share or people will message me or they will go to my stories and kind of screenshot to use, which I don't ever care. But one tip I will give is if you screenshot a story, do it in your story, but don't do it on your main page because it's too big. The story templates are just too big. So it cuts off half of the wording, if that makes sense. So don't do the stories on your main page. I say the more the better. I usually like to have at least 10 stories a day. I load mine every single night. So maybe during the day I was so busy with the kids and I didn't want to take the time to stop and post it in the story, like right then and there. So maybe at the end of the night, that's what I did. Before I go to bed every single night, I load my stories. So I might have a series of business or products, and then I might have a couple personal from my day that I put in there. People aren't looking at the time block. You see, like they're reading your, they're just looking through your story. Might add a couple for, you know, from the beach that when we were in California, and then the next one might be a couple product ones or whatever. Keep it pretty simple, but just make sure you're, again, you're sharing your day. This is where people get to know you. The other thing I want to say is raise your hand or put in the chat if Host to Post has not been your best friend the last month or so. Because it's not been mine. So another thing, just getting creative. I know I talked to Angela earlier today, and she said that she had a couple potentials since I've been putting this in my Power 20s. And if you guys have been doing what I'm about to talk about, post it in the chat. Let me know how it's going for you. If you've been a chicken to do it, cop to it and put that in the chat as well, because I want to get some feedback. So what I started doing is started messaging people that view my story. Has anyone done that yet? Okay. So when you're viewing your story, say the first slide is going to be about, it's like open enrollments or something about the business, right? And then the next slide of mine might be somebody's story. Like maybe I share Chris's story or whomever that I share in my feed about what it's done for them. And then the next slide is another one. Okay. So when people get to the first slide, say I have 50 views. Then on the next slide where I'm sharing someone's story, it's 45. Maybe on the next slide, it's 40. In my mind, that is telling me 40 people wanted to see what's next. They are interested enough to continue clicking or waiting to see the next one. Same exact thing with products. So if you are posting about the wraps, or you're posting about the coffee, and your first one about, you know, skinny coffee models got 50 views, and then the next one where you are showing results has 45, message 45 people. That is my suggestion. People are wanting to continue, those that are wanting to continue seeing what you're sharing, those are potentials. And maybe they are not, they don't have enough time, or they're not feeling comfortable enough to message you, so reach out to them. I am extremely simple with those messages. It's usually a screenshot of my, of whatever it was that they viewed, whatever slide it was. I screenshot it. I send to them with a message that says, thank you so much for viewing my story about the weight loss coffee. Have you been interested in trying it? Super simple. And if you guys are using the app WordBoard, if you have iPhone that I have talked about so much, you can get these messages out in like 2 minutes. You're just sharing a screenshot, pasting, sharing a screenshot, pasting. Adding polls are big. I have, some people feel making them, the polls bigger on the screen, because even if people accidentally vote, it gives you the option to message them. I don't really love that because I think it just wastes a lot of time for me. So I'd rather make it a little bit smaller, use the drawing part to, you know, circle the poll. Maybe like you can type in the GIF arrows and it'll have like little arrows pointing to it to show people to vote, if that makes sense. Let me check the chat because I saw some things pop up real quick. Lisa, so the story is going to be a series of slides or pictures. So if you go look at my story, for example, right now, I have some product and I have some business ones up. You'll see it. There might be something like for the collagen one. I think I did a picture of me. This was last night with the collagen and a face mask on looking rough. And then the next one is, what is collagen? Then the next slide was the benefits. And then there was a few before and afters. So now those that have viewed it, I'm going to message them and just ask them if they're interested. The worst possible thing that you guys are going to hear is, no, I'm not. Like, that's literally the worst thing that can happen. I know that messaging people you've never talked to for a lot is very uncomfortable and you feel like you're cold messaging. If you think about it this way, if you're not doing it with a cold heart and you're keeping your messages very personal, then it really shouldn't feel that way necessarily. You're just asking if somebody is interested in trying something. And I will be honest that if you are someone who is afraid to hear, no, I'm not interested, those are people I wouldn't want in my feed no matter what. I'm very kind and very gracious with my responses because a lot of the people that told me no are now customers or on my team now. So you can't really be afraid of no. And if you message them, which is what you're doing when you're screenshotting your story that they viewed, sending it to them, you are now going to pop up more in their feed, if that makes sense, because you have now connected in Messenger. Let me start the chat one more time. Your pictures just keep adding to the same story. So Lisa, when you go, I'll show on Facebook real quick. I'm not sure exactly what you mean, but I will show you one. Let me find one that I want to add real quick.
Tanya, I think what she means is, like, if she does three slides on a business post, how does she do a product story? Is that what you're saying, Lisa? You just keep adding pictures. As long as you just keep adding and adding and adding, and then it just kind of goes in progression.
Yeah.
Is that what you meant?
Right. But when, Tanya, when you say you do 10 stories, does that mean you do 10 series of pictures?
No, not necessarily. Just 10 different things. So up here where it has like all the little dots, I just want at least 10 a day.
Okay, so a story is basically one of those pictures or posts. Okay, yeah. That was my question, because I'm like, how do you do 10 different stories?
Not yet. So usually, 10 slides in a day is minimum of what I would like to do. Now, the reason why I suggest taking the time in the evening to load your stories is because for a lot of us, our days during the daytime, we're super busy, right? Mm-hmm. For me, I've got the kids, everything else. So if I load, we only have 24 hours. So what I do is I load all of mine before bed. And then the next night before I go to bed, I'm going to go ahead and write down all of the names. If you don't have pen and paper, just screenshot and jot it down when you can. And maybe it's really late at night and you don't want to message those people that late at night. At least you have the names. You've taken a screenshot of what it was that they viewed. So that way you can message them the next day. You've got it set to go, your messages to go out. So for me, that's how I utilize my stories. My views have gone up tremendously, as well as my interaction on Facebook when I'm consistent. I did notice a couple of days I was on vacation that I didn't have as many going as normal. My engagement on my feed was awful. So I really think it has something to do with stories. But the videos is a big thing. I mean, it could be a Fat Fighter demo where you're, you know, photographing the just the cup, you know, where you could be talking, but you don't necessarily have to be on it if that is a concern for you as well. But I think by doing these videos, even with you not on them, if you are someone who is uncomfortable, I think it will help you get comfortable with eventually going live and doing videos with your face. The other thing that I wanted to touch on real quick, let me check the chat real quick. Leslie, so if I do like business stories, I might have maybe like 5. And then same thing with personal. I try and keep whatever I'm talking about 5 or less, to be honest, because I don't want people to get bored and be like, okay, I'm done. So I try and keep it that way. The other thing I wanted to talk about is Instagram TV. And I put this in my Power 20 early in the month. If you don't have an Instagram TV account, get one. These are, let me see if I can pull one up real quick. Okay, so Instagram TV, it's not your stories, it's not in your feed. It is a separate app that you can also link with your Instagram. It can post on your Instagram feed, whatever you want. These are huge. If you are somebody who is comfortable with making your coffee in the morning or making your collagen or whatever and doing a brief with you on camera, though, to be honest, is what I think would be best for Instagram. A lot of these videos are how-tos. With makeup, with hair, with outfits, with cooking and recipes. Don't just make them about business, but if you can, I would definitely start incorporating Instagram TV. These are, it's something public. I believe you can adjust the settings how you want it to be. But they can be viewed publicly. So you're making keto coffee in the morning and a quick little, you know, I've lost 10 pounds by drinking this. This stuff is amazing. I like to keep the mystery for the most part when I am talking about things, not knowing what company and things like that. So I might have that part covered up because I want there to be mystery. I want there to be curiosity for people to reach out. What in the world are you talking about? So it might be, you know, just adding your coffee and you're sitting there filming yourself and doing that. This is a video that you can pre-make and upload to your Instagram TV. So it does not have to be done live. So if it makes you nervous and you're like, what if I mess up? First off, keep in mind that people like a hot mess. The more hot mess it is, the more people will watch. Keep, just like with live videos on your Facebook, keep the caption is so important. That is what's going to draw people in. It's not, I might not post, it works keto coffee. It could, I would be posting how I'm getting skinny drinking coffee. You know, things like that. If you're someone that drinks the ketones, it could be the same caption. You could just get on and not necessarily be making anything and talk about what are your favorite products, what it has done for you, how it is helping you, how you're feeling since started taking it. But Instagram TV is something that I would really incorporate. So, and that's something that can be done like any time of day. Again, that's something you can record and you can upload to it. You do have to create the Instagram TV account. There's an app for it separate from Instagram. Create that. If you have questions, let me know. I know that Alyssa Bilyeu, on one of her lives that she did about social media, she did touch on it. A little bit. I can try and find that video if you guys need it, but I know in the comments of one of the Power 20s, I believe in Diamond Dreams, I posted the video. I wanted you guys to watch for that in the comments. So you can search Power 20 and Diamond Dreams as well. Does anybody on here have anything that has been working with them or like for them with stories or that they want to share that I have not touched on?
Tanya, you said it, but I want to re-say it because I saw it on a video the other day on a Zoom, and it really is the mystery. Like not saying what, I had a picture of my hand holding two Fat Fighters at the end of my story after posting everything that we ate that meal. And then the last slide, I think I said something about, I really don't have to worry about how much I eat when I have these guys. About 7 or 8 people messaged me, what is that? What are you holding? So it truly is, because I'm guilty of saying keto coffee, fat burning coffee, it works, you know, and I think the mystery is really the big thing.
I don't have it works anywhere unless I am speaking about the business and it's my story and it's somewhere mixed in there. And sometimes I even try and abbreviate just IW. I don't have it in my bio anywhere. There is zero black, green, and bling anywhere on my page. It makes me so sad when I see that on posts, like keeping the mystery that it, what does this person have? What are they using? If we are, and I'm going to start shying away from the word TFX, to be quite honest with you. I think it's been overused on Facebook, and I'm going to maybe start sharing program or what have you, if that makes sense. And I think sometimes just posting about one thing, like maybe it's a screenshot of clients' results about how many pant sizes are down or something like that, and talking about it was the cleanse, I'm going to be ixnaying that and just start putting in something like program or whatever. I want to keep the curiosity going about what it is that I do for work. So that's that. I think that messaging people viewing your stories is going to be a game changer if we can do that consistently. I would love to hear anybody on here that will consistently do that starting tonight until end of the week, and maybe shoot me a message and just say like, yes, it worked. No, it didn't. You know, this is what I got from it. Because the more, if I'm doing like when we did the core four and more tasks, when I'm doing the power 20, it's really, we're all just really helping each other. So if I'm going to do the calls and such, I want to know what's working and what's not working, you know, what has been income producing for you and what has not been helpful. So I love getting feedback. So keep me posted on that if you guys choose to do that. But I think that's all I have for you guys, unless you have any questions. Let me check the chat again. Chris, I totally think people want to see you making coffee every day. I follow, I'm going to forget her name. Amanda Buescher on Instagram and on Facebook. Every single day on Instagram, every single day without fail, that chick is making coffee in her Instagram story. I swear, but I also think that it is repetitive. I think people keep seeing it, if that makes sense. So the more they're seeing it, the more I think the interest is there and the curiosity is there. So keep up with that stuff and then just give me some feedback. So I'm hoping that this helped you guys. Also, if you're not sure where to find stories, it can be time consuming to make your own. I do recommend that you do, but sometimes when we see other leaders, we're like, okay, that was good and I'm stealing that. So if you do, I think that's good. If you want to find your own, I see a lot on Pinterest that I like to use. You could really just type in "it works stories." And there's so many ideas that pull up. If you're not like super familiar with Pinterest, for example, here's one that just popped up for the celery. So for me, I'm going to add that one to one of my boards. Then I click on it. So I clicked on the one that I saw on Pinterest, right? Click on it and I scroll down, and other parts of the story that pertain to that one are there. Let's see if I find a good example of it, because I don't know if that makes sense. Okay, so this pulled up on Pinterest for me, Summer Body Challenge, okay? So I've clicked on it, here it is. Now I'm going to click the three dots up here, I'm going to download the image. I'm saving that to my phone. Scroll down, there's the next slide. I'm going to do the same thing, because I really liked that one. Now I'm going to scroll down. There's more to it. Does that make sense? So when you scroll, you can see, I do like to add before and afters to it as well. So if I really like that story, but maybe it didn't have results, I'm going to go find my own results, or you can really just keep scrolling and look for them. Does that make sense? I hope that was helpful. Okay, does anybody have any questions or anything that they would like to add? Everyone's opinions are welcome. No? Okay. All right. Well, I don't want to keep you guys all night. I appreciate you taking the time to be on. I hope this was helpful. I will get the recording uploaded and I'll share it in the team page. Oh, Angie, did you have a question? Or she was waving bye. Okay. All right. I will talk to you guys later. Bye.